Everyone who's ever had a pimple has had an abscess. Even though they're tiny, they're still abscesses. Now, an abscess forms when normal tissue, like skin for example, is split apart and that new space is invaded by nearby pathogens like bacteria. And there are roughly 10 bacterial cells for every one human cell, and they cover every surface of the human body. So any cut or break in the skin, or closed off area within the body, is an invitation for bacteria to dive in and multiply. When that happens, the immune system typically responds, and a battle ensues with the result being pus, a mixture of bacteria, immune cells, and dead tissue. So, in response to an injury, the tissue releases small chemicals in the local area called cytokines, like tumor necrosis factor, interleukin-1, interleukin-6, interleukin-17, and chemokines, which attract nearby white blood cells, which are part of the immune system. It's kind of like yelling for help and being heard by the nearby police. In addition to attracting immune cells, the cytokines also dilate nearby capillaries, which brings more blood to the site, and make the capillaries more leaky, so that the white blood cells that do show up can slip out of the blood and get into the tissue more easily. Oftentimes, the first immune cells at the scene are neutrophils, which release chemicals and enzymes that kill bacteria and dissolve pieces of dead cells, creating a pool of dead material. This is a specific type of acute inflammatory response called suppurative inflammation, which simply means that pus is created in the process. From a macroscopic view, this is sometimes referred to as liquefactive necrosis, because the area of dead tissue turns into liquid. As those immune cells get to a point where they can't withstand the environment, they die too, and become part of that pool. Initially, the debris might be intermixed with healthy tissue, but over time it can coalesce into a single area, a process that's often sped up when more immune cells get involved. Around this pool of pus, a wall of fibrinogen, which is the same protein that holds together blood clots, starts to harden into a barrier. Occasionally, sheets of fibrin form septations, creating loculations or pockets of pus within the abscess itself, kind of like an abscess within an abscess. Even though the pus is largely dead material, there are still plenty of live bacteria within the pus, which makes it highly infectious if it gets spread from one place to another. One of the most common bacteria found in abscesses, especially in the skin or underlying soft tissue, is Staphylococcus aureus. In fact, Staphylococcus aureus releases the enzyme coagulase, which helps speed up the process of building the fibrinogen wall. In contrast to an abscess near the skin, ones that originate deeper in the body often happen in spaces that are already relatively walled off. For example, in the gallbladder, if a stone blocks bile from flowing out, it essentially becomes a new home for bacteria. Bacteria from the nearby small intestine can easily sneak past the stone, crawl into the gallbladder, and multiply, which causes an inflammatory response, and eventually an abscess might form. Typically, these deep infections are a mix of aerobic bacteria that use up all the available oxygen, and anaerobic bacteria that can only live in its absence. As far as symptoms go, abscesses typically cause signs of inflammation, which are redness, warmth, swelling, and pain. For abscesses on the skin, they often come to a head over time, where the tissue overlying the abscess breaks down, allowing it to drain out by itself. People with weakened immune systems, like newborns and those undergoing chemotherapy treatment for cancer, are at particularly high risk because they're not able to wall off the infection, which allows the bacteria to get out of the tissue and into the bloodstream. In these situations, symptoms can also include fever and vomiting. Diagnosing an abscess in the skin or soft tissue is usually done by feeling it, or sometimes with an ultrasound of the area. When an abscess is filled with enough fluid, it becomes possible to feel the fluid move around, and this is called fluctuance. A deeper abscess is usually diagnosed through imaging studies, like ultrasound, CT, or MRI scans. Intravenous imaging contrast can really stand out around an abscess, since the small blood vessels around the abscess remain dilated and leaky due to the constant inflammatory response. And this is called ring enhancement, since it lights up the blood vessels around the abscess. Generally speaking, infections are treated with antibiotics alone. But in order for antibiotics to work, they need to first reach the bacteria, and that's usually done through the bloodstream. Since abscesses don't have blood vessels inside them, the antibiotics can only diffuse into the abscess, and that's not very effective, especially when dealing with a large abscess. You can imagine it getting to those guys close to the edges, but there's no way it's getting to the bacteria in the middle. That's why the most important treatment for an abscess is incision and drainage. In other words, cutting it open and squeezing out or somehow removing everything inside. Doing this thoroughly is important so that all the septations get removed, and that no parts of the abscess remains intact. Oftentimes, there can be a large empty cavity that remains afterwards, and this can easily get reinfected. To prevent that, large abscesses are drained and often packed with gauze to fill the space, until that tissue heals naturally on its own over time. Deeper abscesses sometimes have to be drained with long needles or surgery, depending on the location. Finally, antibiotics are sometimes used even after the drainage to make sure that there are no additional bacteria lingering around. Alright, with all that in mind, here's what you've all been waiting for. A video of an abscess on the earlobe being drained. Buckle up.
Can you see okay there, Miss Jenny?
Yes.
Alright, we're going to make a little stick on this. You ready? And we're getting a whole bunch of pus is coming out right now. You see that? How you feeling?
I'm all right.
We got a whole bunch of pus coming out of there. Wow. Here comes more.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe all that was in your ear. I'll get another 4x4 here. How's your pain? You okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
More coming. Oh, yes, honey. You got to feel that.
All right, as a quick recap. Abscesses are a fun mix of immune cells, pathogens like the bacteria Staphylococcus aureus, and dead tissue. Because there's no blood supply to the middle of an abscess to deliver antibiotics, it usually needs to be cut open so that the pus can drain out. What's up, guys? Thanks for watching. Hope you liked it. Huge special thanks goes to John Gilmore, aka the Cystbuster. He helped both write the script for that one as well as provided that nice video footage, which if you liked it, definitely head over to his channel, The Cystbuster. He's got plenty more where that came from. Also, thanks to Charles B. Davis for helping to write the script as well as Rishi for editing the script. As always, you guys can help support us by donating on Patreon or subscribing to our channel and following us on social media. Also, check out our subreddit, r/osmosis. It's pretty new, so it needs some subscribers. All right, guys. See you later.